Let's work through a FICA tax example problem. Now, before we get to the problem, let's just talk about what FICA taxes are. So your FICA tax rate is 7.65%. But where did that come from? Well, it's made up of Medicare, which is 1.45%, and Social Security, 6.2%, up to $127,200 of gross earnings in a year. So when you add up those two percentages, that's how you get the 7.65% for FICA taxes. Now the example problem. It says employee earnings have shown the following gross earnings for three employees through December 15th. So Mary Irwin, up to December 15th, has made $105,000. Michael Chapman, $123,000, and Pamela Evans is $130,000 so far. Now, each employee's gross earnings for the final pay period of the year is $5,000. The FICA tax rate is 7.65% on gross earnings of $127,200. So what we need to do is compute the FICA withholdings that should be made for each employee during this pay period, this December 31st pay period. So we have all of our information given to us, and we're going to focus first on Mary Irwin. So we draw this chart, right? So we have our threshold at 127,200. That's the magic number when working with FICA. Anything below that will get taxed the full 7.65%. Anything above that threshold only gets taxed the 1.45% for Medicare. So now we plot where she started. She started at $105,000. In this pay period, she made $5,000. So that will take her up to $110,000. But all $5,000 is all below that threshold, below that line at $127,200. So that means that all $5,000 will be taxed the full FICA percentage, the full 7.65%. So we'll take $5,000 times 7.65%, and we see that the FICA withholdings for Mary Irwin should be $382.50. Now we can move on to Michael Chapman. So we draw this chart again, and we plot where Michael Chapman started. He started at $123,000 going into this final pay period. Now with this $5,000 gross earnings, that will take him up above the line, up to $128,000. So we can see that from $123,000 up to the threshold, up to the $127,200, that's $4,200. Those $4,200 will be taxed by the full FICA percentage, because that's still below the line, right? So if we take 4,200 times 7.65%, we see that that portion is $321.30. Now, we also have this portion above the line, up to $128,000. So we have that 800 above the line. That 800, since it's above the line, gets taxed 1.45%. So 800 times 1.45% is $11.60. So when we add those two together, we can find that the total FICA amount for Michael Chapman is $332.90. Now, Pamela Evans. So we draw this chart once again, and we plot where Pamela started off, which is at $130,000. So she's already above the threshold, right? She's starting off at $130,000 going into this final pay period. She makes $5,000, goes up to $135,000, but we can see that all $5,000 of that is above the threshold. So that means that all $5,000 gets taxed 1.45%. So when we multiply 5,000 times 1.45%, we get $72.50. So that would be the FICA withholdings in Pamela Evans' last paycheck of the year. So just to recap, your FICA withholdings for Mary Irwin, Michael Chapman, and Pamela Evans are on the screen now.